Fuel on board, got 50, required is 42. That includes 30 minutes on top of our reserves. Fuel selectors left tank. Electrical switches are off. Avionics master is off. Gear levers down. Cow flaps open. Induction air. And fluid pressure. All right, master switch coming on. Beacon. Navs, not really required now, but we'll turn them on. Priming procedure. All right, that's all good. Clear prop. Looks clear.
Centennial Airport Information Echo, automated weather observation 1353 Zulu, wind 220 at 10, visibility 10, sky clear below 12,000, temperature minus 4, dew point minus 12, altimeter 3038. Digital approach is in use, landing in a parting runway 17 left, runway 17 right, 10 28 also available. Notice airmen use caution for simultaneous operations of closely separated parallel runways. All departures advise ground control and run-up is complete and remain on ground control frequency until advised. VFR departures advise ground control direction of flight. Runway 35 right,
real,
out of service. Runway 35 left, happy.
It feels different.
Out of service. Hazardous weather information for the area available on flight service advise and initial contact of information echo.
Centennial clearance, good morning, Mooney 9058 Victor is ready to pick up IFR clearance to Albuquerque.
Check 34 at Centennial ground, taxi to the north run-up area via Alpha, advise this frequency, run-up complete.
Alpha clearance again.
Yeah, it's Mooney 9058 Victor picking up IFR to Albuquerque.
Mooney 9058 Victor, Centennial clearance clear to Albuquerque Airport via the Denver 2 departure. Radar vectors to Lussie intersection. Lima, Uniform, Foxtrot, Sierra, Echo. Join Victor 389 to Pueblo, VOR, then at Saab. Climb maintain 8,000. Denver departure frequency 132.75, squawk 1456.
All right, Mooney 9058 Victor is clear to the Albuquerque Airport via the Denver 2 departure. Radar vectors to Lufsee. To join Victor 389 there, direct to Pueblo, then as filed up to 8,000. Denver ground 32.75 and 1456 on the box.
358 Victor, read back correct, thank you.
If you're all right, I'll start kind of programming
this. Go for it. All right, my brakes are good. If you want to check yours.
Good. You want all of these fixes in here?
Preferably, yeah.
Okay.
I like to just that way for my nav log, I can kind of keep up with it. All right, IFR pre-departure checklist, ATC clearance to Albuquerque, Denver 2, vectors Lufsee, 389, Pueblo, then as filed. You're programming that. That standard, at least to Pueblo for us. 8,000 is set, 32.75, full set momentarily, 14.56 is set without mode. Brief the Denver 2 real fast. It's basically vectors, if you're good, I'll probably just request 10 and just crosswind slightly from the right. There's a lost comms, basically.
Just maintain a
7,000. Yep. Yeah, exactly. I'm dead yet today. Other than that, the 10 standard takeoff min, so we could do 00. We wouldn't. Anyways, 200 feet per nautical mile. Gotta be doing at least about 300 feet per minute. Should be fine. 10 heading 100 to 6,600 before turning right to avoid the KOA antenna. Top out due to sign ATC radar vectors. Other than that, though, alright, so that's a good VOR check. Technically, don't need it. Nav source GPS initially here. Flight plan's programmed. RAIM on my flight plan. Nav log is green. Departure procedure briefed and displayed. Instrument checks were completed on the taxi out for takeoff checklist. Takeoff briefing. Haven't flown a little bit here, so I'll just brief this. So rotating at 70 and runway 10. Anticipate nose wanting to bounce while it's back pressure. Rotate at 70. Our speeds after that will be 94 to 1,000 feet, and then 113 climbing out. If at any point we lose the engine, 100 is our speed. We'll consider the gear out if we need it. Not a whole lot of places to go. Potentially Parker Road is where we'll be headed, and 470 as well. Other than that, pretty standard. Any questions?
Nope.
I'll plan to fly it if the plane's struggling with performance, just faster rather than 113 all the way up. Might, you know, consider just kind of keeping our speed and climbing out as we need to get up to any altitudes further along the route. And takeoff briefing is complete. Trim set for takeoff and left side. Flaps set for takeoff. Seatbelts, harnesses, check lift.
Set right.
All right, doors latched. Mine's closed.
Set.
Trim transponder is set and out. Altimeters are set 3038, within 75 feet. For takeoff check above line is complete.
Centennial ground, good morning, Mooney 9058 Victor at Charlie 1. Requesting 10 for an IFR departure, and we're ready with Echo.
Mooney 9058 Victor, Centennial ground, winds 210 at 7. You still want room 10?
Yeah.
Still want 217 left for Mooney 58 Victor.
258 Victor, runway 17 left, taxi via Alpha.
17 left via Alpha, 258 Victor.
I hate that too. The whole, you hear that on your side, I'm assuming, as well?
What's that?
The squelchiness?
No, mine does not do that.
You don't hear me, it's all when I talk.
Yeah, and did you try your plug and all that stuff?
Yeah, it does that every time, COM 1 at ground on Centennial, so I always do COM 2, but... Alright, clear left, clear in the high speed, hot spot here, be a right turn north on Alpha.
Mini 58 Victor, you can monitor tower, we'll see you now.
Monitor tower, good morning, Mini 58 Victor. Alright, elevation 5793 at the end here, so that looks good.
Okay.
Mini 9058 Victor, Centennial Tower, fly runway heading, runway 17 left, clear for takeoff.
Fly runway heading, runway 17 left, clear for takeoff, Mini 9058 Victor. Alright, boost pumps, strobes, enunciators are clear, final items. Just pump lights, enunciators for takeoff check, blue line is complete. And approach path is clear on the right, runway heading. Clock started, up to 2 miles. Here we go. RPM, manifold, engine instruments are in green, airspeed's alive. Alright, positive rate, indicating tap the brakes. Here's one. And flaps are coming up.
Got a little bit of cool air coming in with the cavity. Let me know how you need.
Okay.
Mooney 58 Victor, contact Denver departure.
Over to departure, good morning, Mooney 58 Victor. And Denver departure, good morning, Mooney 9058 Victor is with you at a 6.48,000 Denver 2 departure.
Mooney 9058 Victor, Denver departure, radar contact, good morning, climb maintain 11,000, altimeter 3036.
Alright, 3036, climb maintain 11,000, Mooney 58 Victor. Alright, 1,000 feet. Bring the power back. Alright, landing gear is up, flaps are up, power set, boost pumps off, lights are set. After takeoff, check complete.
Mooney 58 Victor, turn left heading 160.
Left turn heading 160, Mooney 58 Victor.
Mooney 58 Victor, climb and maintain 12,000 and clear direct Pueblo.
Clear direct Pueblo up to 12,000, Mooney 58 Victor.
It's noise that you're not enough. I know you're scared of the past, but it don't mean you can't be free.
Like a leap year, I hope every single morning there's sunlight coming. the back windows. You sleep near every single Saturday. Get slower in this combine with a little love. I think there's good things coming your way. And I think there's a lot of angels hearing you pray.
The cannulas are only good up to 18,000. If you're going to go above 18,000, then you have to have a mask on.
Right.
And it's always a good idea to have a mask, like that video was saying, in case you...
That is 294. You know,
you're
number 713514.
Yep. And although oxygen's flowing into your nose, it's best to be trying to breathe through your nose.
Right.
That would be the other thing I would say. Because if you're just breathing through your mouth, you know, you're not really getting...
All right, how's it going, everyone? It's, Dad and I were en route from Centennial to Albuquerque, New Mexico. We're about 56 minutes into the flight or so, showing about an hour and 23 to go. Anyways, we're level here at 12,000 feet, and I thought I'd just kind of show you guys a little bit about Colorado flying. And beyond Colorado flying, this could be really anywhere flying, but more so is the altitude, kind of risks, hazards, and demo on how we use our oxygen system and you know, certain things we're checking when we're using it to be able to fly at 12,000 feet in our airplane. Now, 12,000 feet technically isn't required to use the oxygen if you're above 12,500 up to and including 14,000 feet for a period of 30 minutes or greater, you have to be on oxygen. If you go above 14,000 feet for 1 second, you should be on it theoretically. So anytime for any length of time above 14,000, you'll need oxygen. So you could be at 12.5 continuously without oxygen, and you could even be at 14,000 feet for 25 minutes, say, and be fine, but not really the safest idea to really go, you know, much higher than 12,000.
American.
Anyway, so one of the things we're checking, and I'll show you kind of our view right now at the front window and at the right side.
Spanish Peaks right off the right.
Yeah, Spanish Peaks. Kind of see some other Colorado 14ers way in the background. And you're looking north right now in the video, north, northwest. That's west, and this is kind of south, southwest view here.
Chart with the MEAs, too.
Yeah, we'll do. So you can see we're level here at 12,000 feet, and we're doing about 184, 183 miles an hour over the ground. Our indicated airspeed's 140, and other than that, pretty smooth rides. It's a nice day. You can see.
21A, Roger.
That's the other kind of big thing with mountain flying, or really being near mountains as well, where we're at, is making sure the winds aloft aren't too crazy, and the forecast kind of has sky clear. Don't really want to be.
At your, let's call it 9 o'clock and 40 miles on the reciprocal, I guess, arrival there.
Don't want to be flying when there's too many cloud buildups and kind of potential for bad weather to build. So I'll show you where we're at right now. We're coming down. This is an airway here. For those of you that aren't familiar with that, VFR pilot, it's not instrument rated yet. It's basically like a highway in the sky that allows IFR airplanes to safely navigate on a designated route. That kind of gives us altitude clearance, and depending on the altitude, navigation reception on our dependent, you know, whatever, kind of depending on what method of navigation we're flying. And so we can see these two numbers here. We have an 11,000 and a 10,200 foot number. The 11,000 is what we call our MEA. That's our minimum en route altitude. Over mountainous terrain, I would consider this MEA especially mountainous. It gives us 2,000 feet of obstacle clearance. So essentially the highest obstacle along this segment of the route could be at 9,000 feet is what this is telling us. So we're safe at 11,000. And at 11,000, it gives us that 2,000 foot of clearance, but it also gives us, if we were using the VORs to navigate, like this VOR here, the Cimarron VOR, it gives us, depending on where we're at in the route, it gives us the navigation capabilities to use that VOR. We're not technically within range to use that yet until we cross over this symbol here, and we're 30 miles from that Cimarron. So 80 miles from that, going the other direction, which is where we are at.
What's frequency for Cimarron?
Is 116.7 for Pueblo. Cimarron is 16.4.
16.4?
Yeah.
So I put 16.4 here. I'm just curious, And what's the 2189,
Roger. So you're going to say 25 below.
The radial on that one is the 358 radial, so 200, 158, 178. See if you heard there in that Morse code, it kind of played these digits here. The long ones are a longer aural beep, if you will, and the other ones are shorter beep, so you can kind of make sure by listening to it, if you hear that, that means that we're picking up the Cimarron VOR. The radial for this airway is the 358 radial, but radial's extended.
7905 Bravo Victor, contact Albuquerque Center 132.8.
905 Bravo Victor. Is that what I said? I just want to make sure. You might think our 8's a Bravo.
Who was that last frequency for?
That was for a Mooney 9058 Victor. Contact Albuquerque Center 132.8.
132.8 Mooney 9058 Victor. Good day.
Medevac 3 Alpha.
I think you said Bravo Victor or something, but that's right. I'm going to call him real fast.
And Center Mooney 9058 Victor is with you at 12000.
Remember 9058 Victor, Albuquerque Center. Roger, the Raton altimeter 3048.
3048 for Mooney 905 Victor. It's nice and smooth here today at 12,000.
Number 58 Victor, Roger, thank you. Haven't had too many low guys coming through today, but so far I have had no complaints along your route.
Thank you.
Kirk American 1550-340.
Anyways, just kind of a brief tutorial here on how we kind of use this to navigate. We have the 358 degree radial, which is on this airway. We call this airway, in this case, try and see where it shows it here. Victor 611 is this airway name. So Victor 611 from Cimarron is the 358 radials, but radials only extend outward. And inbound, which would look like this, which is the direction that we're coming, is what we call a bearing, which is 180 degrees opposite of the 358, which would be the 178 bearing 2. And so that's what we have set here. See the S at the top would be south 180. This tick mark here would be 170. So we got about 178 set. And the 2 flag represented, and we're kind of navigating, trying to keep this navigation needle here. That's kind of our course that we're supposed to be flying on, centered.
And you can look here too,
Albuquerque 37 miles,
the VOR changer
set,
points at 30 miles, right?
Passing
yeah.
5,000.
So we're not quite, you know, even though we're receiving it,
Alpha
it's bouncing around a little bit, parsing because we're still low outside of the
range. Yeah, some of those fluctuations that it's indicating right now, the inaccuracy is because we're not quite at the changeover point here. If there wasn't a changeover point, like this symbol here,
American 1777, Albuquerque,
and the airway, so to speak, was a 40 miles long.
Okay,
you switch over at the halfway point, which would be 20 miles. But in this case, we'll wait till 30 miles to switch over.
About 5 minutes ago or so.
American 1777.
Well, we've already switched over, but that's fine. We're not technically navigating on the VORs because we have GPS, which is our primary method. So this is just kind of a tutorial just to kind of show you some other features. Anyways, at 12,000 here, though, I will show you our oxygen, our supplemental oxygen usage. So we have one of these pulse ox, pulse oximeters, that's what it's really called. And this kind of is, if you've ever been to the doctor's office before, and you know, they're kind of checking vitals and that sort of thing, you've probably stuck your finger in something that looks like this before. That's all that it is. And it's going to show us our oxygen levels and our pulse. It's a little flashy, that the GoPro's picking up a little bit flashy. You can kind of see there broken. It's 93, it's my oxygen, and about 90. That's going to fluctuate as I keep looking at it. It's going to go up about 90, 95 though for my
Albuquerque
pulse.
Medevac 83 Alpha Lima, okay. Fuel and
check yours.
At this time, proceed VFR.
Medevac 3 Alpha Lima, roger. IFR cancellation received. No observed traffic between you and the Raton Airport. Radar services terminated. Stock and maintain VFR. Circuit change approved today.
Today, roger. Talking your way out. 83 Alpha.
So as it starts to kind of get, you know, lower, or if you, you know, at all feel ever weird, you know, being up at these altitudes, if you're especially not someone that's used to this type of flying, you're maybe from Hawaii or California, Florida, and you're used to flying a maximum of 6,000 feet, and you're coming up 9,000, 10,000 feet, though it's not required, it might be smart to carry a pulse ox with you and check your oxygen, and maybe carry oxygen with you so that if you see your oxygen level start to go much lower than the normal for your body, then you know you might consider putting the oxygen on. Everyone's is a little bit different on what they, you know, what their normal is. Someone's normal might be 99, one's might be 97. So it's good to kind of check it as well on a normal day when you're just at home, wherever you live.
But we have our oxygen tank mounted back here. And the first thing I'll show you here is, I don't know if you can see it or not, but we have for the cannulas, depending on the altitude, so at 12,000 feet, right by where my thumb is, we want to basically have it at 4.4. So up here, I'm going to turn this, rotate this knob till it's on 0.4. Hard to see with the sun there, but should be on 0.4. Down here is our oxygen. I'm going to turn that on in just a second, but I'm going to get the oxygen mask for Danny. All right, there's yours. So you know, I'm turning the valve on. Okay, and then show the little 18, green.
Sure, that's long.
I'm going to turn over a little bit here real quick.
And this ultimately is what we're going to be looking for, is this little green symbol here. The green symbol shows that there's oxygen flowing.
As compared to if it looked like this, red means there's no oxygen. So you want to make sure that these lines are nice and tight. And eventually once I start breathing in the oxygen, that should turn green.
Actually, let's see here.
I'll do a quick. Yeah, there it goes.
Okay.
Turns green.
All right. 2432, Spirit Wings 1127.
So oxygen is flowing. When you're ready, show us how you...
All right, so we have our oxygen cannulas here. And as my dad was showing you, the cannulas at 12,000 feet require about 0.4 LPM, that's liters per minute.
Liters per minute, yep.
Yeah, and above 18,000, these are certified up to 18,000. Above 18,000, you would have to have kind of a mask that covers both your nose and your mouth. So I'll show you how these work. So these are essentially going to go kind of around my ear. And then as you've probably seen before with people in hospitals and stuff, the cannulas just kind of sit right in your nostrils.
I got the radio.
All right, I'm back online. I don't really need my glasses right now, so I'll put them in here.
All right, when you can fly for a second, I'll put mine on.
Yep.
When you're all situated.
Sure.
And set of sky 3150, 503-70, starting to pick up lights up.
All right, so you guys can kind of see how I have it configured right now. My nose, what I'm going to do one thing is kind of keep this green symbol in sight rather than this falling down into the floor below. I'm going to kind of use one of these clips that come with this from Skyox and just kind of clip it so it kind of keeps it right here. So I kind of have a reminder to look down and make sure that I'm still seeing green and not red. All right, and I got the airplane. Okay, when you're ready.
All right.
I'm on airplane. And so what I'm going to do now that mine's going and I got green, the oxygen flow rate is set. I'm going to put my finger back in the pulse ox and see, it was at about 92, 93.
360.
It's gone up to 96, which is pretty normal.
Thank you.
I'm usually about 97 or so down at the ground, 96, so that's happy there. If you want to check yours, and yours was 90. Fluctuating 92 at the highest maybe, and now it's at 95, so oxygen's definitely helping.
50, copy.
All right, we're coming up on that Cimarron VOR now, about 45 seconds away from it. As we cross over it, we're now going to be navigating, instead of to it, we're going to be navigating from it, meaning going away, and so we'll be navigating on a radial rather than a bearing to, so we'll be navigating on the 181 degree radial, which is essentially what we have set right now. We originally had set the 178 bearing 2, and so it'll be the 181 radial from. So we'll have to move it just slightly.
65, 69, 69.
But in about 10 seconds or so, this flag should flip, meaning that we're over the top of the VOR and then navigating away from it. All right, so now we're navigating from, and I'm going to change this to the 181 radial, which is about there. And as we roll out on 181, and it's going to be real sensitive right now since we're almost right on top of that VOR to indicate correctly. Biggest thing now is just make sure we're breathing in through the nose, out the mouth. This is still showing green, which is what we want, and we are 1 hour from Albuquerque. And Albuquerque Center, Mooney 9058 Victor request.
Number 9058 Victor, go ahead.
I would like to request a climb to 16000, 158 Victor.
Number 9058 Victor, climb maintain 16000, 16000, Las Vegas, altimeter 3051.
3051 and up to 16000, 158 Victor. Right, 3051. Set our altitude up to 16000. 3051 on the altimeter. And then what we'll do here is open our cowl flaps. And I'm going to go full with the prop to about 2,500 RPM or so.
I'll go all the way to 26 if you need to, just so it's off the red.
And then our throttle, we're going to go all the way, and our AGL altitude's 5,000 clear, so I'll do power boost if that works with you.
Yep.
And open our induction air, which gives us another inch of manifold pressure to allow us to go up.
Okay, so because we're climbing to 16, we'll take a look back here, and at 15, it's 0.5, 0.6. At 18, so we're going to increase now to 0.5, and then we'll go up one more. We'll get just a little bit higher up here.
3232,
Epic 1050. Actually, I'll just go to 0.6 right now. The 0.6.
3232 from Epic 1908.
Let's get up to 18,000 feet.
No, my iPad real quick.
For 1908, thanks.
A neat feature with 4Flight. Kind of gives a little reminder there.
Yep.
Caution, cabin altitude.
Just barely got it, but
yep.
I think we
got it. I'll be able to freeze it at least.
So in the Mooney here, it's a fairly cold day, but we climb at about 300 to 400 feet per minute, something like that.
Now about 13,000 feet here.
5730.
Just doing a nice cruise climb, about 120 knots, something like that's what I would probably do.
Sure.
Between 120, you know, VY and 120, something like that. That's probably what I do, you know, try to keep a sustained
sure.
2 to 400 foot per minute climb rate. Be nice and slow.
Sure.
Don't go in above 14, and good reminder that you have to have oxygen on.
Yep. Yeah, so here, federally speaking, is where we have to have oxygen on for 1 second or any time, really, so. And as you can see, we're only doing about 300 to 400 feet per minute in the climb now, coming out of 14,000. And so I'm going to give ATC a call. That's just one of our required reports, radar or non-radar environments for ATC. I'll let them know that we can't sustain a 500 feet per minute climb, so I'll let Albuquerque know. And Albuquerque, Mooney 9058 Victor, just wanted to let you know we're limited with our performance to about a 300 feet per minute climb.
Number 9058 Victor, roger, no problem. Southwest 2900, contact Albuquerque Center, 125.07.
2507, so that's
oh, sure, it's pretty out there.
Yep. So I do have this up to 0.6 liters.
For 16.
Yeah, so it goes 15
Bravo, traffic 11 o'clock, 4
okay,
miles.
So 15 is 0.5,
and 18
is 0.6.
Sure, just
so
round
since
it up.
We're above 15,
yeah.
Or will be, I put it just to 0.6.
The safer thing, yep.
Center climbing 8 points.
Romeo Sierra, Albuquerque, center roger, declines corners altimeter 3053.
So oxygen's gotten even better for me, 97.
3053,
coming out of 14,400 for 16,000.
I've got my suitcase full of contraband. You know I ain't stopping to the border.
Ain't stopping me now.
Ain't trying to see you with another me. Maybe I'll see you when we're over.
Stopping me.
I'm
visual approach to runway 3 at Albuquerque, but we're going to back it up with the RNAV Yankee to runway 3. I've got the RNAV Yankee runway 3, chart 12-1, inbound course 34, taxi at 7400 down to an LPV, decision altitude of 5512. Touchdown zone 5312, MSA 119 within 25 miles of the airport. When we get down there, looking for a PAP on the left side, medium intensity approach light with sequence flashers, may or may not be on during the day. And if we have to missed approach, the published climb to 5,900, then a left turn to 8,000 direct to Albuquerque VOR and hold. Looks like it'll be a parallel entry there with 7 nautical mile legs. Let's see. As we land off of runway 3, the exit plan will be...
Contact Wichita, 120.15, take care, and have a happy Thanksgiving.
We're going to Cutter, you said?
Yeah, Fox 3, Fox 1, or Charlie into the ramp.
Mario, would it? No, this ain't Mario. This is Rogelio. But hey, it's my pleasure meeting you, sir, and maybe I'll talk to you again sometime.
You betcha. Thanks, sir.
You got it.
Try and close the power boost, see if we can still get 21. Not quite, but at 12,000 earlier, it was, I think, 19 inches anyways, 19 and 2,400. I am running a lean fine for what it's worth. Airport's in sight, just beyond that peak. Runway 8, I think, is what I have in sight. Well, be runway 26.
That's runway 26 you're looking at down there?
Yeah. There's the leanest. Cool.
November 58 Victor, flighting 260 Victor for right downwind to runway 3.
I believe the heading was a 220 for a Mooney 58 Victor Vector.
26.
November 58 Victor, heading 260, maintain VFR at above 10,000.
Heading a 260 and VFR at or above 2,000 Mooney 5 Victor.
So pod discretion at or above 10, so you can start the descent visually down to 10. That's what he's basically telling you. Because you know it's going to be a hard to descend, so I would ease it on down. I'm going to shut the oxygen off. You can see real quickly it went to
red. Direct Foxtrot, Tango India. It'll chop off a little distance there.
Another 2 inches.
Yeah, I thought we're direct 14 at the time.
I'm off for just a sec.
Okay.
All right, I can fly for a sec if you want to take yours off.
Your airplane.
Coming up on 10,000.
Yep.
Mooney 58 Victor, affirmative, sir. VFR descends approved, right base to runway 3.
Roger. Mooney 5 Victor, we're leaving at 10-4 on the descent for the right base to runway 3. Airport is in sight.
Centennial aircraft, Albuquerque Aviation Mission, Juliet. Current wind 080 at 12, altimeter 3055.
And Albuquerque Tower, Mooney 9058 Victor at a 9.6 visual with the field in sight, runway 3.
Mooney 9058 Victor, Albuquerque Tower, the wind 080 at 13, runway 3, clear to land.
All right, runway 3, clear to land, Mooney 9058 Victor. Anyway, boost pump. I'll run the descent check once more. Fuel mixture, induction air, that is closed. Altimeters with... That's quite loaded, the altimeters, did you get that?
Simultaneous.
It's right here.
Deployed.
The salinity, yours updated now? I hit quite up.
3055.
3055.
Albuquerque Tower, good morning. Southwest 5486, Rayon inbound, runway 8.
I'll wait till I'm about to beam
Southwest
the FBOs just south of runway 30.
Clear to land, runway 8, Southwest 5486.
The descent coming down. Altimeter's GPS approach briefing is complete, now aids.
I'm assuming you enriched the mixture just a little bit.
I did, yeah.
Yeah, so I wouldn't be afraid to throttle back to idle at this point if you need to, you know, for speed or whatever.
With the gear up before landing check, boost pump is on, gears down, green light, floor is checked, mixture set, prop full, forward flaps planned, full indicated at approach, and seatbelts and harnesses set left. Wind check.
Wind 070 at 14.
Crosswind from the right.
Mooney 58 Victor, any left turn, contact ground point 9, happy to date.
All right, ground point 9, we'll plan Foxtrot 3, happy Thanksgiving, 58 Victor.
Happy Thanksgiving.
In ground, Mooney 9058 Victor off at Foxtrot 3, going to Cutter.
Mooney 9058 Victor, Albuquerque ground, taxi to park via Foxtrot Charlie Golf.
Foxtrot Charlie Golf to park, Mooney 58 Victor. Alright, cow flaps are open, lights are set, trims down, flaps are up, mixture's lean, boost pump is off after landing.